Net zero homes, are they an option for a minority of people who do not live from paycheck to paycheck? Or a solid step on the way to a higher degree of financial freedom? In this video, we'll explore the different approaches, the cost, the payback time, true environmental impact, including supply chain, and the quality of life from living in a net zero home in Germany compared to the US. I'm Kata, welcome to Net Zero Tech. The approaches to achieving net zero homes in the US and Germany differ in various aspects, including policy frameworks, technology adoption, cultural attitudes, and market dynamics. I grew up in Germany and live in the US with my husband and my three kids. I think the US gets a lot of things right, and Germany has frankly acted a bit as a copycat with regards to a lot of the internet-based innovation in the past couple of decades. But I guess Germany has been ahead in one thing, and that's they have been considered a pioneer in renewable energy and sustainable building practices. Policies such as the Renewable Energy Act, EEG, and the Energy Saving Ordinance, ENEV, set ambitious targets for energy efficiency and renewable energy adoption in buildings, including net zero energy standards. The approach in the US varies significantly across states and municipalities. When I worked on my first startup in the US, chatbots for utilities, to increase the participation in clean tech programs, I learned a lot about the lack of scalability in the space, even in software, as a result of the different mentality, regulation, resulting in different APIs, data availability in different parts of the US. Some states have a robust incentive and regulation promoting energy efficient construction and renewable energy integration, while others have less stringent standards. The German building industry has embraced advanced technologies for energy efficiency and renewable energy generation, such as high performance insulation, triple glazed windows, heat recovery ventilation systems, and photovoltaic panels. Technology adoption varies widely and wildly across the US. While there's increasing adoption of energy-efficient technologies and renewable energy systems, the pace and scale differ between regions due to factors like market demand, cost considerations, and availability of incentives. There's generally strong public awareness and support for sustainability initiatives in Germany, including energy-efficient building practices. The cultural emphasis on environmental responsibility has led to widespread acceptance of green building standards. In the US, cultural attitudes towards sustainability vary across regions and demographics. While there is a growing awareness and interest in energy efficient and sustainable living, it may not be as deeply integrated in the culture as it is in Germany. The German market for energy efficient and sustainable homes is well established, with a significant portion of new construction and renovations adhering to high energy performance standards. There is also a robust market of energy efficient appliances and renewable energy systems. The market for net zero homes is still emerging, with varying levels of demand and supply across different regions. Factors such as upfront cost, availability of financing, and consumer awareness influence market dynamics. German government incentives such as subsidies, low interest loans, and feed-in tariffs for renewable energy have played a crucial role in driving the adoption of net zero energy homes. In the US, financing options and incentives for net zero homes vary by state and locally. Federal tax credits, utility rebates, and state-level programs can help to offset the upfront costs of energy-efficient upgrades and renewable energy systems. Overall, while both US and Germany are moving towards net zero energy homes, Germany's more centralized and ambitious policy framework, coupled with strong cultural and market support for sustainability, has resulted in a more rapid adoption of advanced building technologies and energy efficient practices. However, the US is catching up with increasing awareness, policy initiatives, and market demands driving growth in the net zero homes sector. The cost of a net zero home can vary significantly depending on factors such as location, size, design, and the technologies used to achieve net zero energy consumption. However, the cost of building a net zero home in the US typically ranges from 5 to 20% more than a conventional home. This upfront cost can be attributed to the installation of energy-efficient appliances, high-performance windows, superior insulation, and renewable energy systems like solar panels and heat pumps. In terms of payback time, it's difficult to provide an exact figure because it depends again on various factors such as local energy prices, incentives, and the specific design and features of the home. However, typically the payback period for a net zero home in the US is estimated around 10 to 20 years. This means that the savings on energy bills gradually offset the initial higher construction costs overall during that period. Due to the favorable governmental policies, higher energy prices, and a strong emphasis on energy efficiency, the payback period for net zero homes in Germany tends to be shorter compared to the US. It is often estimated to be around 5 to 15 years, depending on similar factors as in the US. However, these estimates can vary based on regional differences. Again, so it's essential to consider local conditions and to evaluate the payback period for a net zero home. Now, how sustainable are net zero homes really if we include the supply chain into the calculation? This is one of the parts where it's easy to get lost in details, but there are ways to quantify it. To give you a ballpark upfront, studies have shown that net zero homes can reduce carbon emissions by 50 to 80% or more compared to conventional homes over their lifetime. Quite a bit. Embodied carbon emissions refer to the carbon emissions associated with the extraction and manufacturing, transportation and installation of building materials and components. Net zero homes typically use energy efficient materials and technologies, but the production process of these materials can still generate significant carbon emissions. Assessing embodied carbon requires evaluating the entire supply chain of materials from extraction to end use. Net zero homes aim to offset the operational carbon emissions through renewable energy generation on-site or off-site. However, the environmental impact of this renewable energy infrastructure, for instance, solar panel or any type of heat pump system, should be considered, including manufacturing, transportation, installation, and end-of-life disposal or recycling. Net zero homes prioritize energy efficiency through insulation, air sealing, energy efficient appliances, and passive design strategies. While reducing energy consumption, the production and disposal of energy efficient materials also have environmental impacts. Assessing the life cycle of energy use and environmental impact of these materials is important. I mean, it matters if you want to get to the bottom of things, I guess. Net zero homes may incorporate water savings, fixtures, and gray water recycling systems to minimize water consumption. However, the environmental impact of water-intensive materials, for instance, concrete, and the energy requirements for water treatment and distribution should be considered. Minimizing construction waste and promoting recycling and reuse of materials can reduce environmental impact of net zero homes. Evaluating the life cycle impacts of waste management practices, including landfill emissions and energy consumption, is important. Assessing the environmental impact of land use, changes associated with building construction and operation, is part of it. This includes habitat deconstruction, biodiversity loss, and ecosystem services degradation. In summary, the assessment of the true environmental impact of a net zero home requires consideration of the entire life cycle of the building, including its supply chain, construction, operation, and end-of-life phases. To get from blah blah to numbers, conducting a comprehensive life cycle assessment can help to quantify the environmental impacts of net zero homes, including their entire supply chain, from raw material extraction to end-of-life disposal or recycling. Living in a net zero home can offer several potential benefits for quality of life compared to regular homes. Net zero homes are often designed with high levels of insulation, air tightness, and advanced heating, ventilation, and air conditioning HVAC systems. This can result in more consistent indoor temperatures, improved indoor air quality, and reduced drafts, leading to greater comfort for the occupants. Since net zero homes produce as much energy as they consume, by definition, occupants enjoy significantly lower energy bills or even eliminate them entirely. This can free up more disposable income for other expenses or savings, enhanced financial well-being. Net zero homes are often equipped with backup power systems, such as battery storage, reducing vulnerability to power outages. This can provide peace of mind during extreme weather events or other emergencies. The emphasis on energy efficiency and indoor air quality in net zero homes typically contributes to a significantly healthier living environment. Reduced exposure to indoor pollutants and allergens, as well as better temperature and humidity control, can lead and typically leads to improved respiratory health and overall well-being. Living in a net zero home allows occupants to significantly reduce their carbon footprint compared to traditional homes. This can contribute to a sense of environmental responsibility and fulfillment, knowing that one's life cycle choices are aligned with sustainability goals. However, the quality of life in any home, whether net zero or traditional, can also be influenced by factors such as location, design, preferences, community, amenities, and personal lifestyle choices. Finally, the upfront cost of building or retrofitting a net zero home may be higher than a traditional home. Overall, while net zero homes offer many potential benefits, the decision to live in one should be based on individual preferences, priorities, and circumstances. With financing options available, they might be much more affordable than you think. Thank you very much for watching. Special thanks to my Patreon members Bill, Sergio, Anna, Victor, Michael, and Tom. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to learn about why the typical insulation in the US has room for improvement. Check out this video. For geothermal heating and cooling systems, check out this video. Have a great time and see you next week. Bye.